Matt Stepp, Dave Campbell's Texas Football here at Matador Stadium in Seguin, here with the head coach of the area round champion LBJ Jaguars, Coach Jamal Finner, after a big win over Alice. First off, Coach, congratulations on the win.
Thank you, man. I appreciate you. I appreciate you being here. You know, we're excited about what we did today. Thank you.
I thought you guys won the game really in the first couple of minutes of the game. You really hit Alice with a knockout blow. You return the opening kickoff for a touchdown, and your special teams on back-to-back kickoffs recovers kind of a squib onside kick. Got to ask you, was that something you guys saw on film, or you felt like you could make them pay in special teams and kind of run a little? It wasn't quite an onside kick, but a squib kick action where you guys could use your speed and recover the ball. Was that something you guys noticed on film during the week?
Well, that's just something that we do every week. You know, that's something we've gotten those recoveries all year. You know, I would say we probably recovered about 10 of them. We just want to put the ball in a position to where the other team has to make a decision on who's going to recover it. And we feel like with our speed, we can get down there before whoever decides to make that decision.
Kicker's gotten pretty good at executing that little pop-up kick. He kind of puts it in the right spot. He's gotten pretty good at it. He's got a pretty high accuracy rate, doesn't he?
Absolutely. You know, it's like he hits a little sweet spot on that, you know, so that's not something that we really just like plan and coach to do. We're just trying to put the ball out of position to where the return team can't take it to the house on us.
All right. Now, pregame, we talked and you thought that they would empty the playbook on you guys and try to throw out a lot of trick plays. And they did and hit you with a couple. But I thought your defense, for the most part, really did a nice job containing the kind of a multiple offense that executes their game plan really well. I thought your defensive line played well and your linebackers really flowed well. Coming in, what was the game plan to kind of try to slow them down a little bit?
I mean, we felt like they were really good offensively, you know, and to be honest with you, we feel like within the scheme of what they've shown on film, we dominated. But they did have quite a few trick plays and throwbacks and things like that, and they just kind of got us, you know. But we feel good that, you know, trick plays are not going to beat us if we just play every down, you know, based on what they show us and the scheme that we plan for that week.
Offensively, you guys were really hitting on all cylinders tonight. You know, the running game was going. Your quarterback was putting the ball in a good spot. How you know, if you guys, especially in the passing game, if you're able to get the passing game and be consistent with that, do you feel like your offense is really, it's got to be tough to stop because of the playmakers you have at the skill spots?
Absolutely, you know, and that's what we feel. You know, we knew it was going to take time for our quarterback to kind of, you know, develop the chemistry outside with the skill guys, because we missed the 7-on-7 and all that offseason work. And so it's just starting to click at the right time. We really focused on our run game with our running backs. And now, you know, they have to try to stop the run game, and we just kind of get it out in space to our skill guys.
Next week, obviously, you know, I know you haven't had a chance to look at Cal Allen on film. You were focused on Alice, but I mean, obviously, you know what kind of tradition that Cal Allen brings to the table. What do you guys think you need to do as these games get tougher each round in the playoffs? What are the next steps that you guys need to take? And what, you know, knowing what you know about Cal Allen, what needs to be, what do the Jaguars need to bring to the table next week to get a win?
Attitude and effort. That's what it's all about for us. We feel like schematic-wise, we can scheme up with the best of them. We feel like talent-wise, we can play with the best of them. So our main deal is focusing on attitude and effort. And if they bring that type of energy every week, I'm betting with my guys.
Question for you. What's the post-game meal of choice after a big playoff win? What's the post-game meal looking like?
One whole box of pizza to yourself.
Pepperoni guy, meat lovers guy. What's the Coach Finner specialty on a pizza?
The Coach Finner special is a meat lovers with the cheese crust. So.
There you go. Coach, congratulations on the win. Good luck next week, and we appreciate what you do for student athletes in the state of Texas.
Yes, sir. Thank you, man. I appreciate you coming out.